All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is our Executive Vice President of Steppe Gold, Aneel Waraich. Aneel, welcome back. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you as well, Steve. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, so last time you and I talked, we talked about you had gotten all your funding to basically go to the next phase of construction at ATO, and that was $150 million. And so let's pick up the point today. You've drawn down some of that in order to get things going, so to speak.
Yeah, exactly. When we updated the market back in July, we announced that whole package, the fully funded $150 million US package. When we put out the announcement, it was definitive term sheet. So I guess maybe to some people, maybe it wasn't as real when you announce something like that. When is the money coming? Is it available now, later, ever? And we've just shown, you know, with this first draw of just about $10 million US, that certainly that's a reality. We are plugging away on our focus on our phase two expansion to bring that online in 2025. And, you know, really, there's not a lot more spend this year for phase two. The $10 million US allows us to chip away at the final design engineering EPC work, put deposits down next month on the longer lead items that we'll obviously procure and install next year, with next year being the real main year for construction and heavy spend and drawdown on that capital. But again, this reinforces the fact that we raise money in a very difficult environment without diluting ourselves and our shareholders by, you know, over 50%, as would be required in a normal project financing package. So very strong, equity-friendly package that we put together.
Yeah, and Aneel, maybe you could sort of talk about the importance of this original design work, because obviously this has to be done properly in a way. So there has to be companies hired and they have to submit drawings and things like that. There's a lot of things that you have to go through. People may be wondering, why don't you just start construction? There's a lot to go through before you get to that initial phase. And you mentioned the supply chain issues as well.
Yeah, exactly. So the good thing is we've actually started phase two construction. So for our listeners and viewers, you know, actually 18 months ago, we actually procured the fixed crushing circuit, which is a very big installation that's installed on site today. So we actually chipped away at some of the construction. Now, the heavy lifting, the final design engineering work for constructing a tailings facility, for the power upgrade to connect to the grid, for the developing the processing plant, the flotation plant. Yeah, this is a big installation. It's four times our current operation. So there's a lot of work to be done in the background there on those final design engineering construction work that our partners, EPC partners, and our local construction partners and builders will need, as will the government, to update our land usage. Yeah.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. We should also update everyone. There's still obviously a lot going on at the site right now. Exploration and drilling programs continuing. You've only sort of scratched about 10% of the claim. So there's so much more to look at, I would think. And that's a big part of the focus as well.
Yeah, exactly. So now that we have kind of phase two moving forward on track with the funding, we can actually focus on extending phase one. Ideally, in an ideal world, we uncover more oxides on the other 90% of our mining license that we're operating on that we haven't really focused on at all in the last few years. So hopefully we have some wins there that we can announce to the market that we've uncovered more oxides, which means our oxide plant can run beyond 2025. We can extend that mine life. That's still more cash flow, more ounces. It's not free ounces, but very cheap ounces when you already have a plant there that's already operational. So that in an ideal world, next year we can come out with some extensions of phase one, and hopefully by the end of 2025 or early 2026, you have phase one and two still up and running, which means our production profile will not be 120,000 ounces for the first 5 years of phase two. It could be that plus whatever phase one is remaining or any additions we make. And again, a reminder on the current asset, we're only down to about 350, 400 meters. So besides stepping out on the mining license on the other 90%, we're still growing at depth. And that's still a big growth opportunity for our phase two expansion and to grow that 12 years of mine life on the current footprint, besides, you know, additional new discoveries across the rest of the property. So yeah, lots still going on. We're still producing. We're still generating some cash to pay our bills and, you know, service this debt as we continue to draw down on more of this project financing facility. We will be able to pay our interest only costs from our current cash flow for the next couple of years. So it's a nice position to be in, to not have to raise money at these crazily dilutive levels. And, you know, as a reminder, you know, our management and board are highly aligned with our investors. We own close to 25% of the company today, and continue to support and buy when we can. And I think this year alone have bought over 2% of the company. So that's a big deal, I think, as a management team as well.
Absolutely. Makes a lot of sense. Aneel, thanks so much. Good update. Good to talk to you as well. We'll talk soon. Okay.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
All right. Aneel Waraich, the Executive Vice President of Steppe Gold.